Well, as the year winds down, a lot of folks are wondering what 2011 will hold, especially for grain crops. And joining us now for his final bottom line of the year is Neil Melanson. And Neil, earlier in the year, there were projections that crop prices were going to be depressed, and they were anything but that. What are prices looking like for grains as we go into the new year?
Well, Mike, we do seem to be ending the year on a positive note. Grain prices are up, and the fundamentals are pointing to a continuation of that upward trend in 2011. However, as American Farm Bureau economist Terry Frankel can probably attest, it's not a good idea to make predictions like the one from the start of 2010 will show you.
Right now, those prices are probably pretty good, may come under some rises as we get into the spring, some of the uncertainties, and so if producers have a risk management plan, it's probably a good time to start implementing, taking advantage of those.
Now, to Mr. Frankel's credit, everything was pointing to a bit of a downturn in the grains, with plenty of stocks and perfect planting weather ahead. By summer, he was wrong, though, so I'm not going to make any predictions, just tell you what to look for in 2011. First is the January crop report and what kind of stocks are remaining for grains. Chances are they'll be below expectations. Second is the South American weather and harvest. It's been dry for many areas down there, especially Argentina, and South America as a whole has planted a little less grain than last year. Another thing coming up soon is the vote on whether or not to extend the ethanol tax credit here in the U.S., which could impact the price of corn. China's demand for grain will be key in 2011, as it has single-handedly supported the soybean markets this year. The government reported record grain production, but traders have doubted it, and subsequent state sales of old grain have flopped, pointing to China being a big buyer once again coming up. Finally, livestock production will get a lot of attention next year. There's a lot of steam behind livestock prices right now as we're still rebuilding the herds, while exports and domestic demand are remaining firm. Higher prices for grain and increased competition from poultry and pork could cut into that, but for the time being, prices are on the rise. The bottom line here is all signs are pointing to good prices for 2011, something that overall is good for both our economy and our farmers. And while that's not exactly a prediction here, Mike, it's nice to end 2010 on a positive note.
Neil, that's no doubt, and I know farmers are hoping that next year will be just as good as this one. Thanks. And remember, you can listen to any of Neil's reports on the Louisiana Farm Bureau Radio Network by clicking on over to our website, twilighttv.org. There you'll also find a list of stations where you can listen in. Just look for the link called LFB Radio Network on the left side of the home page. That wraps up our look back at crop year 2010. Over the next several weeks, we'll bring you some best of programs, including the 2010 convention of the Louisiana Farm Bureau Federation, as well as our trip to Portales, New Mexico, which was the winner of our This Week in Your Town contest. Before we leave you today, we want to thank all the farmers and ranchers and others who've appeared on our program over the year. Agriculture has a tremendous story to tell, and nobody does that better than the hardworking farmers and ranchers of Louisiana. And we want to thank you, our viewers, for joining us here each week. It means a lot to us knowing that you care about agriculture and you want to know more about it. For all of us here at This Week in Louisiana Agriculture, I'm Michael Dana. We want to wish you and your family a joyous holiday and a great 2011. We'll see you right here next year.